Attention, please. Παρακαλώ πάρτε τις θέσεις σας. Please take your seats. Είμαστε έτοιμοι να ξεκινήσουμε. We're about to start. Ο Πρωθυπουργός Κυριάκος Μητσοτάκης θα ξεκινήσει. Prime Minister Κυριάκος Μητσοτάκης has the floor. Παρακαλώ, κύριε Πρόεδρε.
Thank you. Ευχαριστώ πολύ. I would first of all like to thank President of the Council, Charles Michel, who first had the idea of organizing this trip, President of the Commission, Ursula von der Leyen, President of the European Parliament, David Sasolli, Prime Minister of Croatia, Andrej Plenković, for being with us today here in Evros at the Greek-Turkish border. What has happened here over the past days is painfully obvious to everyone. Turkey, in full breach of the EU-Turkey statement, has systematically encouraged and assisted tens of thousands of refugees and migrants to illegally enter Greece. It has failed and will continue to fail should it pursue this strategy. This is no longer a refugee problem. This is a blatant attempt by Turkey to use desperate people to promote its geopolitical agenda and to divert attention from the horrible situation in Syria. The tens of thousands of people who tried to enter Greece over the past few days did not come from Idlib. They have been living safely in Turkey for a long period of time. Most of them speak Turkish fluently. And Europe will not be blackmailed by Turkey over the refugee issue. We stand ready to support Turkey in dealing with its refugee problem and find a solution to the Syria conundrum, but not under these circumstances. My duty is to protect the sovereignty of my country. At the same time, Greece is also doing Europe a great service. The border of Greece is the external border of the European Union. We will protect them. Greece expects tangible solidarity from the European Union. And I can tell you, the presence of the entire European leadership here at the outer borders of the Union sends a clear signal to everyone. But let's be honest. Europe has not been up to the task of dealing with the migration crisis. I hope this crisis will serve as a wake-up call for everyone to assume their responsibilities. Now allow me to say a few words in Greek. Κυρίες και κύριοι, μαζί με τους συναδέλφους μου, είδαμε από κοντά τι ακριβώς συμβαίνει εδώ. Μακριά από την ύπουλη προπαγάνδα των fake news που κυκλοφορούν για να κρύψουν την αλήθεια. Και αυτή είναι μία. Η Τουρκία κάνει πράξη την ομολογημένη απειλή της και επιχειρεί να στείλει δεκάδες χιλιάδες κατατρεγμένους ανθρώπους παρανόμως στην Ελλάδα ζητώντας ανταλλάγματα. Αν και ίδια έχει πλέον χαρακτηριστεί ασφαλής χώρα, αποτελώντας de facto πλέον την πατρίδα πολλών από αυτούς, εξακολουθεί να τους χρησιμοποιεί ως γεωπολιτικούς μοχλούς για τους δικούς της σκοπούς. Παραβιάζει έτσι κατάφορα την κοινή δήλωση με την Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση, σύμφωνα με την οποία οφείλει να συγκρατεί πρόσφυγες στο έδαφος της, αλλά και να εμποδίζει τις παράνομες οδούς προς την Ελλάδα. Δυστυχώς, η Τουρκία έχει μετατραπεί σε επίσημο διακινητή μεταναστών. Η Ευρωπαϊκή Ένωση και η Ελλάδα δεν αποδέχονται αυτή την κατάσταση, την οποία αποδεικνύουν όλα τα τεκμήρια. Δημόσιες δηλώσεις του Προέδρου Ερντογάν με την απειλή ότι θα ανοίξει τις πύλες των μεταναστών προς την Ευρώπη. Τα βίντεο που δείχνουν δωρεάν μετακινήσεις χιλιάδων ανθρώπων με τουρκικά λεωφορεία και συνοδεία στρατοφυλακής. Οι μαρτυρίες όσων έφτασαν στον Εύρο, όπως και τα μηνύματα των δουλεμπόρων που γράφουν για δίθεν ανοιχτά σύνορα. Αγαπητοί φίλοι, το πρόβλημα αυτό δεν είναι πια προσφυγικό και μεταναστευτικό. Συνιστά μια ασύμμετρη απειλή στα ανατολικά σύνορα της Ελλάδος, που είναι και σύνορα της Ευρώπης. Και η παράνομη εισβολή χιλιάδων ανθρώπων παίρνει τη μορφή της επιβολής του εθνικού μας εδάφους, με εμπροστοφυλακή, συχνά ανθρώπους άγνωστης προέλευσης, αλλά και αγνώστων σκοπών, που δεν διστάζουν να χρησιμοποιήσουν απροκάλυπτα βία για να εισέλθουν στην ελληνική επικράτεια και εκτοξεύουν δακρυγόνα που χρησιμοποιεί ο τουρκικός στρατός. Είναι υποχρέωσή μου να περιφρουρήσω την ακεραιότητα και την κυριαρχία της χώρας μου. Και αυτό θα κάνω. Ενώ είναι υποχρέωση της Ευρώπης να βοηθήσει την Ελλάδα και αυτό θα κάνει. Αντιδρούμε λοιπόν με γνώμονα την προστασία των συνόρων μας, αλλά και την ασφάλεια ολόκληρης της Ευρώπης. Κινούμαστε απολύτως στο πλαίσιο του διεθνούς και ευρωπαϊκού δικαίου. Πάνω απ' όλα ωστόσο, όσα συμβαίνουν στα ελληνικά σύνορα αποτελούν διεθνές πολιτικό ζήτημα πρώτου μεγέθους και ως τέτοια πρέπει να αντιμετωπιστούν. Από την πλευρά της η Ελλάδα έδειξε ότι μπορεί να υπερασπιστεί τα δικαιώματά της με όπλο την νομιμότητα και την αποφασιστικότητα. Μόνο στις τελευταίες μέρες οι δυνάμεις μας απέτρεψαν πάνω από 24.000 απόπειρες παράνομων εισόδων στον Εύρο και στο Αιγαίο. Προχώρησαν σε δεκάδες συλλήψεις ανθρώπων που παραβίασαν τα σύνορα και πέτυχαν πολλές διασώσεις μεταναστών στη θάλασσα. Θέλω να συγχαρώ τις γυναίκες και τους άντρες της Ελλάς, των ενόπλων δυνάμεων, του λιμενικού για το έργο που επιτελούν, αλλά και τους πολίτες που συμπαρίστανται αυθόρμητα στο δύσκολο έργο τους. Οι απειλές λοιπόν του κύριου Ερντογάν δεν πέρασαν. Προσέκρουσαν στην ενότητα του ελληνικού λαού, στο φρόνημα και στην επιχειρησιακή ικανότητα των παιδιών του, αλλά και στην ευρωπαϊκή αλληλεγγύη, που είμαι σίγουρος ότι θα εκδηλωθεί ακόμα πιο αποφασιστικά τις επόμενες μέρες. Το μήνυμα είναι ξεκάθαρο προς όλους. Μην επιχειρείτε να μπείτε παράνομα στην Ελλάδα. Δεν θα τα καταφέρετε και αναλαμβάνετε ακέραια την ευθύνη των επιλογών σας. Η Ελλάδα έχει αποδείξει την ευαισθησία της, φιλοξενώντας πάνω από 100.000 ανθρώπους. Όμως ένα διεθνές πρόβλημα δεν μπορεί να το σηκώσει μόνο μια χώρα. Μάλιστα, όταν αργεί μια δίκαιη λύση, ο ανθρωπισμός μετατρέπεται σε αγανάκτηση. Γιατί η αλληλεγγύη δεν μπορεί να μένει μόνο στα λόγια, αλλά να απευθύνεται και προς τους Έλληνες πολίτες, των οποίων ήδη απειλείται η ασφάλεια, η περιουσία και η κοινωνική γαλήνη. Άλλωστε, βοήθεια στους κατατρεγμένους μπορεί να προσφέρει μόνο ένα κράτος. Δεν υπάρχει όμως κράτος χωρίς ασφαλή σύνορα. Και δεν υπάρχουν δικαιώματα χωρίς κράτους δικαίου. Η Ευρώπη μέχρι σήμερα απέτυχε να βρει κοινή λύση σε αυτό το σύνθετο πρόβλημα. Κάποιοι βολεύτηκαν να κλείσουν τα μάτια και να αφήσουν τα κράτη που βρίσκονται στα εξωτερικά σύνορα να αντιμετωπίσουν μόνα τους αυτή τη διαρκή κρίση. Η παρουσία σας εδώ είναι η καλύτερη απόδειξη ότι αυτό αλλάζει. Κλείνω ευχαριστώντας και πάλι τους Ευρωπαίους ηγέτες για τη συμπαράστασή τους, η οποία σίγουρα θα γίνει και πιο έμπρακτη. Και τονίζω ξανά τη χαρά και την υπερηφάνεια την οποία ένιωσα δίπλα σε όσους υπηρετούν εδώ, στον ακριτικό Εύρο. Ήμουν, είμαι και θα είμαι κοντά τους, εκφράζοντας το σύνολο των Ελλήνων. Παραμένω όμως αισιόδοξος. Πρώτα, η Ελλάδα αναγνωρίζει ότι η Τουρκία μπορεί να βοηθήσει το προσφυγικό. Χρειάζεται τη στήριξη της Ευρώπης, όχι όμως υπό το κράτος απειλών. Η Ελλάδα και η Ευρώπη δεν εκβιάζονται, αντιδρούν και δεν προκαλούν, συζητούν. Και ελπίζω αυτό να συμβεί σύντομα. Σε κάθε περίπτωση όμως τα σύνορά μας είναι αδιαπραγμάτευτα. Όπως αδιαπραγμάτευτη είναι και η θέλησή μας για μια αποτελεσματική ευρωπαϊκή πολιτική στο θέμα. Οπλισμένη με το δίκαιο και τη λογική, θα πετύχουμε. Thank you again for your presence here. And let me now give the floor to the President of the Council, Charles Michel.
Thank you. First of all, dear Prime Minister, dear Kyriakos, I would like to thank you for this occasion to visit the Greek borders, because it's important in such a situation not to stay in Brussels, but to be present on the ground and to have the best possible understanding about what is happening and what happened the last days here in Turkey. I would like also to express our support for all what you did with your security services, with your team, with your government, the last days. There is a strong, important point. The Greek borders are the European borders, and what you are doing is important for Greece. It's crucial as well for the future of the European Union. And our presence together here in your country today, it's a very strong message that we would like to send to the Greek people, to the European citizens, and to the rest of the world. We are together. We are together because we consider that the borders protection is essential. And of course, it's crucial to act in a proportionate manner and to show respect for the human dignity and to show respect for the international law. And we trust you, we trust your government, because we know, even if the task is very difficult, even if the task is very complex, that it's very important as Europeans to protect our borders and at the same time to show respect for the international law and for the human rights. You mentioned many important points. And indeed, we have an agreement with Turkey on migration. And indeed, it's very important to implement this agreement. That's why, at the European level, we will continue to guarantee the implementation of this agreement, but we expect from the Turkish side that they will also respect what they promised in the framework of this agreement. On Syria, it's important to make all the possible efforts in order to give more chance, more possibilities for a political solution, for a diplomatic solution. And that's why we are also supporting all the efforts made by the United Nations in order to give more possibilities, in order to make more progress. This is a tragedy. This is a tragedy for many people, and it's very important to be committed in order to give more hope and more positive perspective in the future. Today, the High Representative Borrell is in Ankara in order to express the European message and to express a strong European message. Wednesday, we'll have in Brussels a meeting with the ministers, the European ministers of internal affairs, on home affairs, and Friday, we'll have in Croatia a meeting with the ministers of foreign affairs. It means that we are acting, that we are united, that we are together, and in the next days, in the next weeks, we will continue to work together with you, with your government, with all the open institutions, in order to show that we are able to protect our borders, that we are able to show unity when we need to be strong and to be united. We are able to show that it's possible. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Charles. Ursula.
Thank you very much, Kyriakos. I want you to thank you for the invitation. Indeed, these are extraordinary circumstances, and we've just been to the border area and have seen how tense and how difficult the situation is. The Greek authorities are facing a very difficult task in containing the situation, and I want to thank the Greek border guards and the coast guards. I want to thank the civilians, the police, the servicemen and servicewomen, and I want to thank Frontex for that tireless effort. It is important to me to be here today with you and to tell you that the Greek worries are our worries. This border is not only a Greek border, but it is also a European border, and I stand here today as a European at your side. I also want to express my compassion for the migrants that have been lured through false promises into this desperate situation. We have come here today to send a very clear statement of European solidarity and support to Greece. Our first priority is making sure that order is maintained at the Greek external border, which is also a European border. I'm fully committed to mobilizing all the necessary operational support to the Greek authorities. Following Greeks' request, Frontex is now getting ready to deploy a rapid border intervention team. Frontex is preparing the deployment of one offshore vessel and six coastal patrol vessels, two helicopters, one aircraft, three thermovision vehicles, 100 border guards in addition to the current 530 border guards will be deployed by Frontex at the land and at the sea borders. Secondly, we can provide financial assistance of €700 million to Greece. This consists of €350 million, which is immediately available, plus an additional €350 million that can be requested as part as of an amending budget. The financial assistance is for migration management generally, for setting up and managing the infrastructure needed. Thirdly, we launched the civil protection mechanism based on a request made by Greece. Through this, Greece can receive assistance in terms of medical equipment, medical teams, shelters, tents, blankets as needed. Kyriakos, Charles, Davide, Andrej, and I will remain in very close contact in the coming days and weeks to make sure that we deliver all the support that is needed. The situation at our border is not only Greece's issue to manage, it is the responsibility of Europe as a whole, and we will manage it in an orderly way with unity, solidarity, and determination. Those who seek to test Europe's unity will be disappointed. We will hold the line, and our unity will prevail. Now is the time for concerted action and cool heads and acting based on our values. Turkey is not an enemy, and people are not just means to reach a goal. We would all do well to remember both in the days to come. I thank Greece for being our European aspida in these times.
Translate aspida as shield. Thank you very much. Davide.
Sì, grazie. Grazie al primo ministro, ai miei colleghi. È molto importante essere qui insieme alla politica, al governo, al Parlamento della Grecia. Però se dovessimo tornare a Bruxelles e le cose dovessero continuare come sono andate avanti fino ad ora, probabilmente anche questa si rivelerebbe un'occasione non utile, perché noi abbiamo una necessità, e lo vediamo tutti i giorni, di rafforzare una politica comune per l'immigrazione europea. E sono molto colpito dal fatto che tanti governi continuino a non esserne consapevoli. Se un anno e mezzo fa si fosse dato retta al Parlamento europeo e si fosse proceduto a una riforma del Trattato di Dublino, probabilmente noi oggi non saremo in queste condizioni. Per il Parlamento europeo, chi arriva in Grecia arriva in Europa. Chi arriva in Italia, a Malta, in Spagna, arriva in Europa e deve essere l'Europa ad avere una politica per l'immigrazione, a condividere il peso dell'immigrazione, a procedere a una redistribuzione equa che garantisca il fatto che in Europa si garantiscono le libertà e i diritti delle persone. Ma se non avremo una politica comune per l'immigrazione, come potremmo garantire tutto questo ed essere fieramente leader nella difesa dei diritti umani? Abbiamo bisogno di una svolta, e la presenza oggi del Presidente della Commissione, del Consiglio e la presenza del Parlamento vogliono dire questo, un invito all'Europa ad affrontare decisamente la possibilità di avere una politica comune per l'immigrazione. Nello stesso tempo siamo qui per dire grazie alla Grecia, ai cittadini della Grecia, a tutti coloro che stanno cercando da tanto tempo, non da oggi, di proteggere le persone, di fare in modo che non si aggiungano sofferenze a sofferenze. Poi siamo qui anche per un terzo motivo, dire alla Turchia che noi vogliamo dialogare e la Turchia rispetti gli accordi. Credo che questo sia il segno per il Parlamento europeo di questa visita. Ma dobbiamo tornare a Bruxelles, ed è questo l'impegno che dobbiamo prendere, beh, per formare davvero una politica comune. Questo è quello che ci chiedono i cittadini della Grecia oggi, che, i cittadini del Mediterraneo, di tutti i paesi del sud dell'Europa, ed è affrontando una sfida che non si consuma in un fatto di cronaca, ma avendo una strategia di medio e di lungo termine. Poi permettetemi una considerazione, perché in Grecia sono presenti tanti minori, migliaia di minori, minori non accompagnati, e io penso che un impegno che voglio prendere, ma insieme naturalmente alle altre istituzioni, è quello di avere una strategia per loro, per i minori non accompagnati. Dobbiamo custodirne il futuro, proteggerne il futuro, e credo che su questo l'impegno dei governi europei debba essere molto più forte di quello che è stato fino adesso, anche in generosità, perché spesso le politiche di alcuni governi europei sono stati improntati non alla generosità ma al proprio interesse. Credo che lo spazio europeo meriti qualcosa di più, e credo che questo sia il modo anche per rispettare il grande impegno che le autorità, le istituzioni e i cittadini della Grecia stanno mettendo in questo momento su questa emergenza. Grazie.
Thank you, Mr. President. Andrej.
Thank you very much, Kyriakos. Ladies and gentlemen, dear Ursula, dear Charles, caro Davide, on behalf of the Croatian presidency of the Council of the European Union, we came here today to, first of all, express our solidarity and support to the Greek government, but also demonstrate our common European determination to help Greece and to find a European response to this new migratory situation or potential crisis. I would like to commend Kyriakos for having altered the policy of Greece when it comes to its protecting its border, and that is to say not to allow illegal migration on its territory. Because, as Ursula has said, Greece is now the shield, the real external border of the European Union, and the guarantor of stability for the entire European continent. I'm saying this also as a Prime Minister who is on one of the countries who is on so-called Eastern Mediterranean, Western Balkans migratory route. And therefore, it is in the interest of all of us that Greek border remains non-porous, and therefore much appreciation for the briefing and for the efforts for the Greek police and Greek military, firemen and the civil protection, which have been already engaged over the past couple of days. I brought here with me my Minister of Interior, who will chair tomorrow the extraordinary session of the Council of the Ministers of Interior. This is a right signal that we are acting timely and that we will send the right messages, messages of support, even with the rapid teams that could be deployed, with the contribution of Frontex, with the contribution of EASO, as well as the financial contribution which Ursula said is already available. At the same time, we will send a message to Turkey that the good relations between Turkey and the European Union depend on both of us. We will seek to find a political and diplomatic solution which will de-escalate the situation that we have today here in Kastanjes, just witnessed a few hours ago. Our support as presidency will be being committed at all levels to address this issue and to prevent another situation that we have all gone through in 2015 and 16. I have many times said no other phenomenon has influenced the political landscape of Europe and its member states as has this migratory crisis that we have seen in the past 4 or 5 years. Therefore, we should learn the lessons from that experience, stay together, hold the line, and support the efforts of the Greek government which we have just witnessed. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Andrej, very much. If I were to conclude by thanking you all for for being here. It is very important to have this expression of solidarity by all the institutions of the European Union to Greece, to the Greek people, to the Greek armed forces, to the Greek police, for the work that they do in protecting Europe's borders. As you said, Andrej, this government is pursuing a different path when it comes to border protection. And we are sending a very, very clear signal that migrants and refugees cannot be used as instruments, as pawns in a geopolitical game. They are the true victims of these types of policies. And this is an approach that cannot be deemed acceptable. If Europe is to protect its citizens, it needs to be able to protect its borders. And this is exactly what we, what Italy, what Spain, what the other countries who are on the external borders of the European Union is doing. At the same time, we cannot do this on our own. The whole purpose of putting together a Frontex force was exactly to share the burden of border protection. Hence, all the assistance that the European Union can provide us would be very, very much appreciated, because this, as you saw, is a difficult task. At the same time, the fact that we're able to manage our borders and limit illegal migration to the maximum possible does not mean that we should not reach a final compromise in terms of changing our existing asylum policies. This is a topic that has bothered us for many years. If I want to be a little bit bold and provocative, we have not used the time wisely since the last migration crisis to address the situation effectively. It's about time that we do it now. We need to be able to demonstrate effective burden sharing when addressing this complex problem. We need different types of policies. We need to be innovative. We need to think out of the box. And frankly, we cannot afford to have that many free riders within the European Union who pass the burden of managing the external borders to those countries who, by virtue of geography, happen to be placed where they are, while at the same time not assuming any responsibilities in terms of managing this problem internally. And I know that there are interesting ideas coming out of the Commission. We'd be very much looking forward to contribute towards finally reaching a solution on this very delicate file. I would like to thank you once more, all of you, for being here. These have been testing times for our country. Lots of people haven't had any sleep over the past 3 to 4 days in order to do their job. We've proved that we can do the job. We can protect the borders. We will continue to protect the borders. And I honestly hope now that the threat of actually sending hundreds of thousands of people to Europe has been materialized without success, that it is time to maybe try a different approach. It is the one thing, at least, we owe to those people who sometimes feel that they have nothing to lose, but today are used as instruments to promote other ambitions. Again, thank you very much for your presence. It means a lot to the government, but primarily it means a lot to the people who live here in this part of the world, of Greece, in Evros. It means a lot to the entire Greek society. Thank you again very much for being here.
Thank you.